Powercon connectors. These mains connectors are used widely in event technology, like most lasers have one of these sockets in. And they're decent, you know, and they're widely available. You can get cheaper clones, although I can't guarantee the safety of those clones. Anyway, sometimes you just need to extend one. And the way you do that is with a coupler like this, which has got a socket on one side. And then you can get a Powercon extension, which is blue at one end and gray on the other. And you can just put them together like that to make a longer, a longer cable. These couplers are bulky and expensive, so I want to see if I can make a Powercon socket that's in line in with the cable. You can only get the sockets like this as panel mount sockets. Can I convert this into an inline cable socket? Let's give it a try. Quick search on Thingiverse and I've immediately found this power cable adapter by a user called Joyver. I've printed it out and tested it and it's almost perfect for what I need. The only thing I would say is it's a little bit bulky and you need to glue the Powercon socket in to this tip here, which is probably fine, but I want to see if I can maybe grip onto that a little bit better. And I also want to make it just a little bit more streamlined than this. It's using quite a lot of material and it's actually quite bulky. So let's see if I can maybe redesign it. Some time has passed. I've made a few different revisions, but I'm pretty happy now with what I've got. You can see the original design here on the right. Some things that I really love about this design is that it's got a 3D printed thread. That's not actually something I've done very much before, so it was really nice to learn a bit more about how that worked. The other thing I really love about it is this thread on the other end actually receives a standard waterproof cable gland. So that's really helpful. We've got some very cheap parts that can actually hold onto the cable really safely. But I think you can see in my revisions that my version is a lot smaller. I also added some little recesses here on the outside just to help you kind of screw it up a little bit and just to make it feel a bit more designed. The other minor change that I made is in the lid. You can see there that there are just some little cutouts. So it's not completely circular, there's little sort of square edges. And that's because, in fact, I haven't mentioned it yet, but you, with this, with both of these designs, you need to kind of snip out the edges of the panel mount Powercon socket. And what you're left with usually is like a couple of slightly flat sides. So what I thought is that I could use those flat sides to better grip on to the socket. So then particularly while you're twisting the connector in or when you're doing it up, it should hold on to that socket a little bit more. Probably still need to glue it, but let's wait and see. A few more tests later and I've got this version, which I'm pretty happy with. When you first print these out, the threads are a bit sticky. I've actually already worn these down a little, but when you first do it, you're gonna have to really tighten that up tight, unscrew it and screw it up and try and loosen it. Maybe use a bit of silicone lubricant or something like that if you're finding that it's really sticky. And of course your 3D printer will have to be fairly decent quality to get those threads to work. And here's that cable gland that I mentioned. They're so cheap, you can get a big bunch of them for a few pounds, and that screws in perfectly to the other end. Again, like when you first print it out, you're going to need to just move that back and forth, screw it in, unscrew it, make sure it the threads work fine. Okay, so we've got that sorted. Next up, I'll show you what you've got to do with the socket. Essentially, you've just got to snip all the corners off. I just use wire snips, but I guess you could use some kind of belt sander or something like that if you prefer. Or even a Dremel. I've been careful to leave a few kind of square edges, and in order to make sure that it fits, I've got this here, which is a 3D print of just like the first section of the lid, so I can more easily just see how well that fits in. And once I've snipped it down to a point where it fits comfortably, then I know it will fit in the actual ring. I'm pushing it down really hard, the end needs to be flush. That seems to fit pretty well, so let's put the rest of it together. As you screw up the case, it should push the Powercon socket right up to the end, so it's important that that's really, really tight. Now I'm going to test it with a Powercon plug. And you can see I can twist it left and right, and it doesn't seem to move inside the case. So I think that one works pretty well. Of course, if it was at all loose, there's no reason I can't just add a bit of epoxy or something like that to hold the socket inside. So now let's wire it up. Essentially, you just use exactly the same crimp connectors as you would if you're wiring up a panel mount version. I guess it could encounter a bit more twisting than it would if it was inside a panel. This is mains power we're talking about, don't take any risks. I can't guarantee the safety of this setup at all, so always get a qualified electrician to check your connections. As this cable gland tightens, it squeezes on the cable and should hold it tight. It's the kind of thing that if you need, you're really going to need it. My particular use case was this. So I've got a socket here going through to a plug there. And so the cable that powers my lasers, I just pull out and put this in between the cable and the laser. And I've got another cable coming out here to a 12 volt power supply. And I use these to power my EtherDream laser controllers. Just one of those things that's like super awkward to do in a live situation. Get like a 12 volt jack supply into a laser that's rigged up in a lighting rig. Anyway, quite a quick, fun little project. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time.